Hi, today we're going to learn about a musical motif and how to use that in our composing. So what is a musical motif? Well, a motif is a big fancy word for just a short idea. It's usually not more than 3 to 5 notes, and it can be very simple, but taking that idea and making it into an idea that you will expand or that you will develop to make a bigger piece. So today we're just going to work on and learn how to make a musical motif. Our lab today is called Hot Chocolate Motifs because you're going to start out today. First of all, you're going to watch on the iPad, you're going to watch a short little video about motifs and what they are, and just to give you a better idea about those. The second thing you're going to do after you've watched the video is you're going to go over here and you're going to choose the mug. There's 3 mugs over here, and each one is for a different age level, so be sure and check the labels to see which one is your level. On this one, this is the primer level. So primer level, you're going to pick 4 marshmallows and 1 stick. So you're gonna pull out those marshmallows, and what I'm gonna do is we're gonna take this laminated staff that's over here, and you're just gonna place it down here on the piano. And you're going to pick a marshmallow, and I'm gonna pick 4 marshmallows. And each marshmallow has a note name on it. You can see that this one is the note G. So I'm going to put that on a G on the treble clef. I'm going to start over at the left, as you can see, so that my notes will be read like I read them in music. Okay, here's my second one. My second one is E. So I'm going to put that on the line E. All right, my third marshmallow I'm going to take out. This is the note D, so I'm going to put that in space D here. And then my last marshmallow is also a D. So I have, that was my four marshmallows. Now I'm going to pick a stick. These have rhythms on it, and I'm going to use these rhythms to actually make the rhythmic part of my motif. So a motif not only has to have a melody, but it has to have a rhythm as well. So now that I've got my 4 notes, now I'm going to take my piece of staff paper over here. And please, everybody, just take one. I have enough for one for everybody. So now I'm going to take those, and I am going to take the notes that I've drawn over here, G, E, D, and D. And I am going to write those on my piece of paper. So here's a G. I'll color that in, and E, actually don't color them in right away because you don't know what your rhythm is going to be, so I'm just drawing, as you can see now here. I'm going to go ahead and put a stem on each one. Okay, so you can see now, it's probably going to be backwards, but I've drawn G, E, D, D, because those were my notes I drew. Now I'm going to look at my rhythm stick, and you can see here I've got 2 eighth notes, a quarter note, and a half note. So I'm going to make my notes I just drew into that rhythm. So I've got 2 eighth notes, a quarter note, and a half note. So now, as you can see, I don't know if you can see that very well, but I have my rhythm is the same as on my stick. G, E, D, D. And if I play that now, I'm going to come over here and play that on the piano. So now that sounds like this. Or in the right octave. And that is my motif. That's the start of my song. When you've done that, I want you to take your piece of paper and I want you to put it in your folder, and I want to see that next week at your lesson so that we can use this to start a composition. Thank you very much. Have fun.